greetings. I'm sure the first thought you had after reading the title is not what I'm about to say. I'm not going to talk about the slaughter of saints and the Antichrist Mahdi breaking the cross. Nor will I discuss the coming persecution and criminalization of the body of Christ. Instead, I want to talk about this word, this name, Christianity. Acts 11:25. Then Barnabas departed for Tarsus to look for Saul. And when he found him, he brought him to Antioch. So for a whole year Barnabas and Saul met with the church and taught a significant number of people. Now it was in Antioch that the disciples were first called Christians. So for a whole year Barnabas and Saul met with the church. They met with the church for a year. And at some point the moniker Christians was applied to the disciples of the Messiah. It is mentioned in churches, but not with consistent clarity. The Messiah was promised to the seed of Abraham. Jesus was a Jew. Jesus would not call himself a Christian. In fact, Jesus made a very clear statement, and it was not to a Hebrew. He said it to a Samaritan, a Gentile. John 4:22, you worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews. This is the core of the message of the prophets. God established his eternal covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. Genesis 17:19, then God said, yes, but your wife Sarah will bear you a son, and you will call him Isaac. I will establish my covenant with him as an everlasting covenant for his descendants after him. God reiterates this commitment in Genesis 17:21. But my covenant I will establish with Isaac, whom Sarah will bear to you at this season next year. Leviticus 26:42, then I will remember my covenant with Jacob, and I will remember my covenant with Isaac, and my covenant with Abraham as well, and I will remember the land. Exodus 2:24, so God heard their groaning, and God remembered his covenant with Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. God promised to bless all mankind because of this covenant with Abraham. Genesis 18:18, Abraham is to become a great and powerful nation, and all the nations of the earth will be blessed through him. Genesis 12:3, I will bless those who bless you, and whoever curses you, I will curse. Through you, every family on earth will be blessed. Acts 3:25, and you are heirs of the prophets and of the covenant God made with your fathers. He said to Abraham, through your offspring all peoples on the earth will be blessed. God promised to make a new covenant with the seed of Abraham. Jeremiah 31:31, behold, days are coming, declares the Lord, when I will make a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Hebrews 8:8, for finding fault with them, he says, behold, days are coming, says the Lord, when I will effect a new covenant with the house of Israel and with the house of Judah. Luke 22:20, and in the same way he, Jesus, took the cup after they had eaten, saying, this cup, which is poured out for you, is the new covenant in my blood. The new covenant was established by God by the shedding of Yeshua's blood. 1 Corinthians 11:25, in the same way he took the cup also after supper, saying, this cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. This is the core of the message of the prophets. The God who made covenant with the Jewish people through Abraham would expand his covenant to offer salvation to all nations. John 4:22, "You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know, for salvation is from the Jews." Jesus did not say, "And I shall establish a new religion called Christianity." Allow that to sink in briefly. Jesus did not say, "And I shall establish a new religion called Christianity." If your identity is defined by your denomination, I encourage you to prioritize the Word of God over the doctrines and traditions of your particular sect. And if you call yourself a Christian, I have an admonishment for you. You need to identify yourself as the seed of Abraham by faith. Galatians 3:28, "There is neither Jew nor Greek. There is neither slave nor free. There is no male and female, for you are all one in Christ Jesus." And if you belong to Christ, then you are Abraham's seed, heirs according to the promise. Stop what you are doing and listen carefully. You worship the God of the Jewish patriarch, Abraham. You read, believe, and follow the message of the Jewish prophets. You follow the new covenant established by the Jewish Messiah. Tell me again why we Christians hold ideas and anger against the Jewish people. We are Jewish. What can be more Jewish than to worship the Jewish Messiah? You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know. For salvation is from the Jews. Salvation, God's gift, God's Holy One, God's Messiah, came through the line of Abraham. Romans 11:13, "But I am speaking to you who are Gentiles. Inasmuch then as I am an apostle of Gentiles, I magnify my ministry, if somehow I might move to jealousy my fellow countrymen of Israel and save some of them. For if their rejection is the reconciliation of the world, what will their acceptance be but life from the dead?" The rejection of Messiah had to happen for our great benefit, the Gentiles' great benefit. And it is but for a little longer until the time of the Gentiles be fulfilled. If the first piece of dough is holy, the lump is also. And if the root is holy, the branches are too. But if some of the branches were broken off, and you, being a wild olive branch, were grafted in among them, and became partaker with them of the rich root of the olive tree, do not be arrogant toward the branches. But if you are arrogant, remember that it is not you who supports the root, but the root supports you. Do not be arrogant toward Israel and the Jewish people. The root is holy. The root is God. The root gives all of us our life. You will say then, "Branches were broken off so that I might be grafted in." That is true. They were broken off because of their unbelief, but you stand fast through faith. So do not become proud, but fear. For if God did not spare the natural branches, he will not spare you either. Behold then the kindness and severity of God. to those who fell, severity, but to you, God's kindness, if you continue in his kindness. Otherwise, you also will be cut off. I want you to think about what fear Paul is talking about. Proverbs 1:7, the fear of the Lord, or Yahweh, is the beginning of knowledge. Fools despise wisdom and instruction. Reverential fear and awe of the God of heaven. I will never apply the word awesome to anything or anyone except God and God alone. Only God is awesome. So how is this the end of Christianity? I think we need to end the thinking that somehow Jesus was a Christian. Realize that you are saved by the Jewish Messiah, the God of Abraham. You worship what you do not know. We worship what we know. For salvation is from the Jews. Do not despise the natural branch. Instead, be thankful and respectful of what that branch endured. The blessing and burden of the natural branch resulted in their blindness for a time, for your benefit. But that blindness is beginning to lift. In these last days, understand, you are grafted into the seed of Abraham as an adopted son of God. And worry less about the title Christian, and give no thought at all to any denomination. Follow Jesus and his Spirit, not a dead tradition. His word is life. His Spirit is life. Dead traditions are, well, dead. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.